Hey, what is going on? This is Adrian from Creativio AI, and in this video, I will show you and also give you some great tips on how to improve your prompts and how to position your product in the right way so you don't have duplicated products and extra bottles behind your product photography scene. All right, so let's get started. First off, navigate to product photoshoot and upload your image. Now, if you're uploading images that are huge, this won't work. So please go ahead and shrink your image to about 1024 by 2024 and upload then, all right? So this is a limitation that we have from AI engines. So if you're uploading images that are too big, it won't show up here. So please go ahead and use smaller sized images. Now, I will position my product. Also, another tip that I can share with you is position your product right. So just imagine the scene you want and where the product should actually stand. Now, in my scenario, I want to position somewhere here because I'm going to generate a table right under the product. So this seems like the perfect position for me. Now, I already made a prompt here. I've been testing around, iterate a couple of things, and found out that the best way to generate a product photography is by not mentioning the product name in your prompt, all right? So avoid that, just focus on creating the perfect backdrop for your product photography, all right? So I don't have anywhere mentioned this is an argan oil dropper in my prompt, all right? So my prompt looks like this, an advertising style photography backdrop. The backdrop is a wooden, now I describe the backdrop, all right? I tell them what it is, and then I describe the background in details. The background is a wooden table positioned on the bottom half of the image with argan seeds sitting on it. In the background, behind the table, so I'm also telling it what exactly is that we want to have behind the table, we have a steel gradient of, this is the color code for argan seeds. I've researched that online and found out this is the color shade that I want to create this product photography in. And once I give them all these details, now I'm giving some extra keywords that's going to make my product stand out, like studio lighting, studio quality photography, hyper realistic product photography scene, epic cinematic advertising setup. All right, this is my prompt. I'm not mentioning the product anywhere in my prompt. Now I'm going to leave here four generations. I'm going to leave the render strength to strong, which means this is going to take about 50 steps to generate. The prompt strength, I want it to be very strong, so I can go with strong as well. Let's go with very strong for the purpose of this demonstration. And now I'm going to click on the advanced photography settings. And because I know this is going to try to generate some sort of bottles behind my scene and around it, let's say, let's say I don't want to see bottles, bottle skincare, set skincare product, jars, dropper. I don't want to have ugly deformed, ugly deformed. There's a lot of negative keywords that you can use to make sure you're not getting these things in your final generations. But for now, I think this should be enough. So let's go ahead and let's say I don't want to see oil droppers. Overlaying, duplicate. All right, I don't want to see this in my shot. So I'm mentioning in the negative prompt. So again, if you want to see the negative prompt, you need to click on advanced photography settings. Now, if you want to use this magic editor to construct your prompt, you can do so. But if you're doing that, you need to click on the use this field. So it's going to use this this prompt field instead of the free one that we have over here. Now, let's go ahead and just make sure I copy this to my clipboard. I also have prompt magic, which is going to take my prompt and enhance it. But for this reason, I don't want to do that. I just want to generate as it is using my own prompt. So let's see what we're getting. Now this takes about 20 seconds per image generated, and we're generating four, so we're gonna have a wait time of about 80 seconds. Usually it can take lower than that, but I found out that this is the generation time per image. All right, so let's see our generations. All right, okay, so we got this. This is looking actually really good. It blended my seeds with some other seeds in the background, a bowl of argan seeds behind it. So this is looking actually not that bad. This is also looking very good. It uses the depth of field. It used the bokeh effect. Even if I didn't tell it to use it, it just made sense for it to use. So look at my product standing over here on the table, perfectly positioned. And this one, again, it's mixed with another seed. So everything blends out beautifully. And we also have this corn pine over here in the background. This is beautiful scenes. Now, again, this is another great one, but it kind of did some stuff to my dropper over here. So let's go ahead and generate this again. Maybe we get a batch of four better looking photos. So again, with the AI, it's all about iteration. It's all about finding the perfect prompt and then iterate upon that prompt until you get the perfect product photography. We have no control on what the AI is going to give us. So it's always going to be something new, always going to surprise us with some new generations. Now, would you look at that? This is actually perfect. We have a scene that is quite cinematic over here with all these argan seeds surrounding my base product. I don't have duplicated products behind my shot. Now, here, the problem is that I have a candle lightning right behind my product, which is something I don't really want. It's not looking that bad, but I don't want it. This is actually looking great. And this is actually with a studio lightning right in the background. So let's go ahead and do some iterations with our prompt. Let's get rid of this backdrop over here. The back is a wooden table positioned on the bottom half with the image with argan seeds decorating the table. Let's say decorating the table. In the background behind the table, we have a still, let's say we have a gradient wall with this color code, color palette. Let's iterate upon our prompt. Epic cinematic advertising setup, epic cinematic scene. All right, let's just hyper realistic. Let's just get rid of that. Studio quality, photography. Let's also put color correction, hyper realistic color correction, fog and mist. Let's try this prompt over here and see what we get. So you can see it's all about improving your prompt and getting the better results is by using the right prompt. Now, because I promised you, I'll show you the difference when you're mentioning the product name, you are going to actually ruin your product photography for now. Now, would you look at that? This is actually perfect product photography for my needs. I have a bowl of argan seeds. I have seeds laid upon the table. I have mist and fogs behind the scenes. So it's really making it that cinematic look I was looking for. This is actually even better. Look at that. This is kind of created a lightning effect upon my product over here. And this is actually looking very good. But right off the gate, you can see that I'm getting good results with my product standing on the table with no products generated behind it. So it's kind of focuses on creating me the perfect backdrop, the perfect product photography scene setup. So that's what I'm trying to focus right now. Okay, I'm not mentioning the product. I'm not telling the AI what it is that it needs to generate, because if I would do that, and I'm going to show you what happens, if I'm saying that it's an argan oil drop picker, it's going to generate another one in the background, which is a known issue with the AI engines at this point. Now, look at this. This is actually beautiful scene with steam and fog and mist around my product shot. And look at that. This is also looking very, very good. Another one, very, very good with smaller balls and a big ball behind it. And yeah, this is actually not that bad. So let me just demonstrate you what happens if I say an advertising style photography of an argan oil dropper bottle, right? Now look what happens, right? This is where we're actually trying to find a solution so that we can also tell the AI engine what the main initial product is and it doesn't duplicate it. But this is something that we're working on. It's going to show up in our new AI engine. So please be patient. We're going to solve this problem so you can mention the product name as well in the prompt. But for now, the best results are getting if you're not mentioning the product product name. Else, you're going to get some strange generations over here. You can see it generated another bottle behind my bottle, which is a known issue that we're trying to get rid of. Again, we're going to have a bottle behind a bottle again. So this is something that we don't want in our generations, and that's why we're not mentioning the actual product in our prompt. All right, so these are the tips that I can give you to get these amazing product photography shots with your image. So this is it. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope these tips and training is helpful for you to generate your perfect product photography. Now, again, keep in mind, to summarize this, all you need to do to get the best product images is actually position your product the right way and also create the right prompt for it, all right? So just imagine where it's going to be positioned, what are the elements that's going to surround it with, and what are the highlighting keywords that you want to have in your prompts. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions, feel free to comment on it or ask me or send me an email. We'll gladly help you generate your product photography to the next level. Thank you so much, and I'll catch you up in the next one. Cheers.